In the last lecture, we have seen that if we have a function fz equal to u plus iv, and if these partial derivatives are satisfied, that is del u upon del x is equal to del v upon del y, and del u upon del y equal to minus del v upon del x. So if these two equations are satisfied, so these equations are called CR equations, Cauchy-Riemann equations, and we have seen that these are the necessary conditions for the existence of the derivative. Now we see that how what are the sufficient conditions for the existence of derivative, and later we define analytic function. So if we have so sufficient condition, so if u del u upon del x, del u upon del y, del v upon del x, del v upon del y, if these partial derivatives are continuous and CR equations are satisfied. CR equations, these two equations are satisfied. So if these four partial derivatives are continuous and CR equations are satisfied, then fz is differentiable at a point z naught. So fz is differentiable at a point z naught. So these are the sufficient condition for the existence of derivative. That if for a function fz equal to u plus iv, if these four conditions are satisfied and these partial derivatives are continuous, then the function is differentiable at a point z naught. Now we define analytic function. A function fz of a complex variable z is said to be analytic if analytic at a point z equal to z naught. So we are taking the point z equal to z naught. Suppose the point is z naught. If fz is differentiable at z naught and in some neighborhood of z naught. So this is the condition for the analytic function. This is the definition of the analytic function, that the function fz is analytic at a point z naught if fz is differentiable at z naught and in some neighborhood of z naught. Now we see what is this condition. So suppose that this is some region R, and suppose we are taking the point z naught here. So if the function fz is differentiable at this point, the function fz is differentiable at this point and in some neighborhood of z naught. So it means it is not only differentiable at a point only, but it should also be differentiable in the neighborhood of z naught. So if these two things are satisfied, then we say that the function fz is analytic at the point z naught. Similarly, suppose we take another point z1, so we will say that the function is analytic at a point z1 if it is differentiable at z1 and in some neighborhood of z1. So if it is differentiable at z1 and in some neighborhood of z1, then only we can say that the function is analytic at the point z1. So this is the definition of the analytic function. Now we see what is the relation between the analyticity and the differentiability. So from here also we can see that analyticity implies differentiability. This means if the function is analytic, then it will also be differentiable. But the converse, the opposite is not true. That if the function is differentiable, then it may or may not be analytic. It may be analytic with some condition, it can be analytic, but it is always not analytic. For this, we will see an example that if the function is differentiable, but it is not analytic. So this is the definition of the analytic function at a point z naught. We can say that if the function is analytic in the whole region R, if it is differentiable at all points of R, so it means if it is differentiable at all points of R, then it will be analytic, because if we take any point, then it will be differentiable at that point and some neighborhood of the point. So in a region R, if the function is analytic, if it is analytic at every point of R. Okay, so now we see one example. So let us take an example. Fz equal to mod z square. Okay, so now we see here that this is the function mod z square. That we can write this, since we have z equal to x plus iy, so this means mod z equal to under root x square plus y square. So it means fz equal to x square plus y square. So if we compare this with u plus iv, so from here we can write u equal to x square plus y square and v equal to 0. Okay, so now we find the Cauchy-Riemann equations. So we differentiate this u with respect to x. Del u by del x, we get from here 2x. Del u by del y, we get from here 2y. Now del v by del x, so derivative of v equal to 0 will be 0, and del v by del y, this is also 0. So these are the four partial derivatives. Now if del u upon del x equal to del v upon del y, which is the CR equation, del u upon del x equal to del v upon del y, so this means 2x equal to 0, that is x equal to 0. Similarly, if we take del u upon del y equal to minus del v upon del x, okay, so del u upon del y is 2y equal to minus del v upon del x, so it will be 0. So from here again we can get y equal to 0. So we here we see that CR equations are satisfied only for x equal to 0 and y equal to 0. That is, when will be 2x equal to 0? The 2x equal to 0 will be only when x equal to 0. 2y equal to 0 will be only when y equal to 0. So we are getting only one point 0 comma 0. The point is 0 comma 0. So we are getting only one point 0 comma 0 at which the CR equations are satisfied. Okay. So it means the function may be differentiable only at 0, 0, 0. But for analyticity, what we need? We need that the function should be differentiable at this point and also in some neighborhood of this point. But here we can see that if we take x equal to 0.1 or if we take x equal to 1, so if we take x equal to 1, then CR equation will not be satisfied. Or if we take y equal to 1 or y equal to minus 1, then CR equation will not be satisfied. It means CR equations are satisfied here only for 0, 0. So this function is differentiable only at 0, 0. Why we can say that the function is differentiable? Because CR equations are satisfied and partial derivatives are continuous. Here we can see that partial derivative del u upon del x is 2x, del u upon del y 2y. So these are continuous and this is 0 and this is 0. So all partial derivatives are continuous and CR equations are satisfied. It means the function is differentiable at 0, 0. So this function fz is differentiable at 0, 0, but fz is not analytic at 0, 0. So this function fz equal to mod z square is differentiable at 0, 0, differentiable at origin, but it is not analytic at origin. So here we can see the difference, that the function may be differentiable, but it may not be analytic. But if a function is analytic, then it will be differentiable. Now we see that what are the necessary and sufficient conditions for analytic function. It means we have defined the analytic function. The definition is the function is differentiable at a point and in some neighborhood of that point, then the function will be analytic. But how can always we can check that the function is differentiable at, in every neighborhood or in some neighborhood? So this cannot be checked. So for that, we should have some conditions. We should have some condition, and if those conditions are satisfied, then we can say that the function is analytic. So here we are writing the necessary and sufficient conditions. So first we have already seen that if the function is analytic, then it should be differentiable. And for differentiability, we have already said that CR equation should be satisfied and the first order partial derivatives are continuous. But for the necessary for the analytic function, we have that if U, V and their partial derivatives. All partial derivatives. Partial derivative means del u upon del x, del u upon del y, del v upon del x, del v upon del y. So if u and v and their partial derivatives are continuous and CR equations are satisfied. Okay, so CR equations are satisfied and u, v and their partial derivatives are continuous, then and these should be at some point. So we can write at some point z equal to z naught. Okay. Then fz is analytic at the point z equal to z naught. So first always check the analyticity at some point. Okay, because we cannot check at every point simultaneously. So we check at some point. So sometimes the point is given, sometimes we find the point. So if this function fz, at the point z equal to z naught, if CR equations are satisfied and u and v and their partial derivatives are continuous, then we can say that the function is analytic. So these are the conditions. By satisfying these conditions, we can check that a function is analytic or not. Now, if fz is analytic, then u and fz means fz equal to u plus iv. So, if fz equal to u plus iv is analytic, then u and v are called conjugate functions. And u and v are called conjugate functions. So if fz equal to u plus iv is analytic, then u and v are called conjugate functions. Now, if fz equal to u plus iv is analytic. So if fz equal to u plus iv is analytic, so if this function is analytic, it means it will satisfy CR equations. So we have del u upon del x equal to del v upon del y and del u upon del y equal to minus del v upon del x. So if the function fz is analytic, that means it satisfies these CR equations. Now we have these equations, we are differentiating again. So we will differentiate this equation del u upon del x again with respect to x. So if we differentiate again with respect to x, so this is first order partial derivative. It will, if we differentiate again with respect to x, it will be second order partial derivative. So it will become del 2u upon del x2. On the left hand side, it will be second order partial derivative with respect to x, and on the right hand side we have del v upon del y, partial derivative of v with respect to y, and we are differentiating this equation with respect to x, so it will become del 2v upon del x del y, because this is already partial derivative with respect to y and we are differentiating with respect to x. So So it will become del 2 V upon del x. So that is mixed order partial derivative with respect to V. Next, we have del 2 U upon del y 2. So we are differentiating now U with respect to y. So we are differentiating U with respect to y. So del 2 U upon del y 2 will be equal to minus, this will become del 2 V upon del y del x. Because it is already with respect to x and we are differentiating it with respect to y. So this will be minus del 2 V upon del y del x. Okay. So we get these two equations. Now we are adding these two equations. Suppose this is equation number 1. Suppose this is equation number 2. So we are adding these two equations. So adding these equations 1 and 2, we will get del 2 U upon del x 2 plus del 2 U upon del y 2. So on the right hand side, these equations, we already know that del 2 V upon del x del y and del 2 V upon del y del x are same. Mixed order partial derivatives are same, that is, it does not depends on the order x and y, order of x and y, if the given function is continuous. So here we have taken the depth that is analytic, other than analytic means these are continuous. So this will be 0. If we add these two, this will be 0. Okay. So we are getting this equation del 2 u upon del x2 plus del 2 u upon del y2 equal to 0. And similarly, we can get the same relation for V. We can get del 2 V upon del x2 plus del 2 V upon del y2 equal to 0. So this equation, what this equation is called? This equation is called Laplace equation. This equation is called Laplace equation. Okay. So it means if the function fz equal to u plus iv is analytic, then this function is satisfies Laplace equation. This function means the function u satisfies Laplace equation. Similarly, the function v will satisfy Laplace equation. So we know that if a function satisfies Laplace equation, then if the function u satisfies Laplace equation, then u is called harmonic function. And here we can get the same equation for v also.